and the LA County Sheriff's Department overhead with a helicopter. But very erratic driving. We understand that there's even been erratic driving with the suspect that is not even being pursued right now. So we are way behind this. It'd be almost impossible to see our helicopter from where we are. But there is the presence of the LA County Sheriff's Department helicopter overhead, and they are coordinating with local agencies right now. We don't know if there have been any injuries. We do believe there's a suspect and a passenger in this vehicle. So we don't know exactly what's going on, but right now we are going back westbound on Imperial Highway, headed back toward that 605 freeway where it meets up with the 105, and we are watching to see when the officers might make a move. We don't know if there's going to be a spike strip or any attempt to stop this driver, but right now they feel that it's just safer to let this suspect drive on city streets without the presence of police department with law enforcement behind the suspect. But it's still a very dangerous situation. You don't know why this guy woman was driving at such high speeds. We believe, again, it originated in the Inland Empire. At least that's what we're being told by law enforcement. So at this point, the suspect wanted for reckless driving only. We don't know what they found when he tossed a bag somewhere in the Lakewood area, we believe. He was driving behind an apartment building in an alleyway, drove up to a pickup truck, and then tossed a bag into the back of that pickup truck, then took off again. And that is where we find ourselves now. It looks like we are going to be going southbound. We'll get the location for you. And it looks like getting back onto the freeway. So we'll see where this takes us. But, again, we've climbed up to a point where it would be almost impossible to see us. But law enforcement does have a helicopter overhead. I'm going to have to break away for just a moment to make a quick radio call. TV5 is 2,000 feet. Upland. Copy. Thank you. Equipment violation. Okay, thank you. I'm back. Well, tons of traffic is what is driving the suspect to make that transition in the shoulder. We saw this earlier when we first arrived on scene. He was coming northbound on the 605, and there was a lot of traffic, and so the suspect moved over into that right shoulder. And we've seen, we were just told, by the way, that it started in Upland, and it was an equipment violation, so something probably wrong with the car. We're not sure what that means, but at this point, the suspect is now northbound 605. Officers, we can't see them in our picture, but I can tell you that they are certainly back there, at least four or five black and whites that are behind the suspect. They are actually stuck in some of this traffic, moving onto the right shoulder as well, not visible from the suspect right now. But again, northbound 605, as we make our way up toward the 5 freeway, there are at least two helicopters, one from the California Highway Patrol and one from the LA County Sheriff's Department. And it looks like we've been here before. It looks like the suspect is now making that transition road from the North 605 to the 5. Earlier, we saw him go southbound on the 5, got off at Imperial Highway. And so sort of a big circle as the suspect is making his way through the Southland here. Again, starting in Upland, speeds of over 100 miles an hour. California Highway Patrol was behind this suspect, and they elected to stop and let this guy go into surveillance mode. We're going to get around this tree here. It looks like the suspect may have been trying to back up because, and it looks like the passenger door is now open on the vehicle. Again, we're going to try and swing Sky 5 around here for a better look here so you can see what's going on here. But lots of traffic here on the northbound 605 transition. It looks like this one may have been, and it looks like the right, the passenger is out of that vehicle. There you can see that back into the car. So maybe perhaps take a look, see if the California Highway Patrol was still behind them. And from our view, we can see that they're back there. I don't know that the suspect would be able to see from where, or the passenger even, for that matter. But at this point, looks like the suspect or the passenger got back into the car, and now they are off the freeway. And we are. It looks like we're going northbound now, perhaps even a turn to get back onto the freeway. So, again, very difficult situation for officers. He's on the wrong side of lanes now, wrong side of the road, northbound. What street is this? It looks like Studebaker and Florence now making a westbound turn on Florence. And, again, California Highway Patrol is right there behind him going underneath the 605 freeway, maybe getting back onto the freeway. There is a transition road that will take the suspect. But, no, I think the suspect continues now on Florence and continues westbound. So a difficult situation for officers right now. They are about a mile behind the suspect. No lights, no sirens, but the suspect clearly knows that he or she is being tracked right now on Florence, now westbound here from the 605. Five's got you. That's right. It was shortly before we arrived on scene. We were listening to the traffic between California Highway Patrol and the LA County Sheriff's Department, and we could hear that the suspect pulled into an alleyway and then pulled up next to a pickup truck of some sort, tossed a bag, that's what we heard, and then the pursuit or the surveillance kept going. So we believe that, again, the strategy from law enforcement right now seems to be paying off right now, as this driver drives around Southland streets here in a far less erratic movement, and they really believed that it was going to get too dangerous to continue the pursuit, so they elected to go into the surveillance mode, which they are now doing on Southland streets. But even with the surveillance mode, even knowing that they aren't necessarily being pursued, this driver continues to drive in the wrong side of the road, stopping, sometimes trying to back up on the freeway transition roads. So, again, even without the pursuit, it is still a very dangerous situation for drivers here in the Southland. Now on Florence, moving westbound, the next freeway that we would get to if we kept going westbound would be the 710 freeway. So now moving toward the City of Commerce. The bag toss that we're talking about happened down in Lakewood, and that was just a few moments before we got overhead here in Sky 5. But there you can see, suspect far right side of the roadway. And even without being pursued, the suspect was driving in opposite lanes of traffic, blowing through red lights. So, again, equipment violation, that's how it all started. In Upland, very high speeds. California Highway Patrol elected to let the pursuit go and let the air unit take it over, and that is where we are right now. The air unit from the LA County Sheriff's Department is now northbound Paramount, and it looks like he's making another westbound turn and into a residential neighborhood, and that changes the game just a little bit as well when you get into some of these residential neighborhoods. I believe due to COVID, there's probably not a ton of people that are out on the roadway right now, but suspect driving in this neighborhood. Again, we started it in Upland. That's where the pursuit started. And then went into surveillance mode, made it down to Lakewood, came back up to Norwalk. And here we are right on the border between Downey and Commerce, as the suspect is now southbound on Tweedy. And you can see that not incredible high speeds, but when there is a stop, a red light or another car, the suspect takes actions to avoid any kind of stoppage. And then if we can just pull to a little wider shot as that corner we rounded, we'll show you that there are officers. Actually, it's too far back, Rich, so let's not do it. I got Rich Prickett here on the camera right now doing a great job following the suspect. And you can see that the speedometer there on the right-hand side of your screen, we're now back on Florence, and we're really not going that fast. So, again, this surveillance mode, it brings down the temperature of the pursuit a little bit. It brings down the speeds, And law enforcement, in the event that the suspect tried to stop and carjack or pose danger to the public, officers just a few moments behind, they'd be able to speed right in and catch up with that suspect. So it's something that we don't see very often, but it seems to be paying off in this case, surveillance of what was a pursuit that started in Upland. You know, I see them all over, but it's a difficult move to make right now, so we're not going to be able to show it to you. But they're about, I would say, a city block, maybe a quarter mile right now behind, and they're mixed in with some of the other traffic. But what's happening is you'll have one officer that will get out in these intersections, stop the traffic so that four or five trailing black and whites can come back in and be ready. And also officers are being noticed in advance as we make our way into Commerce. So, again, a mutual aid situation where there's multi-law enforcement. We've got the L.A. County Sheriff's Department. Certainly the Commerce PD has been made aware of this. You've got CHP. And some of the chatter we heard earlier was that the CHP would take over when it gets onto freeways. But until that time, it's primarily a surveillance by the L.A. County Sheriff's Department and the California Highway Patrol. Copy. And 7-Eleven, as you guys come back to the east, 5's over here. I've got you both in sight. Yeah, absolutely. We've seen blown red lights, wrong side of the road, I think that law enforcement, made a decision. They said, we are not going to continue this pursuit. It's just simply too dangerous, too reckless right now. But they do have the surveillance of the helicopter. There you can see on the left side of your screen, that looks like probably the Commerce Police Department. We're on surface streets right now. So you can see we're on Clara Street in Bell Gardens. But again, still very reckless, passing that red car there, now moving back southbound. So we're going to maneuver Sky 5 here in a way that we'll be able to keep up with the suspect. Now there are multiple law enforcement helicopters overhead right now and several that are also trailing in vehicles, but well behind this car. So almost an accidental bump in there with the suspect with a police car. Certainly the suspect's got to know that law enforcement is back there. In fact, there we come back with a northbound turn. So sorry, Rich, every time I make a turn, the suspect turns, and it's a lot of hard work for Rich in the backseat here of Sky 5. But now back northbound here on, it looks like Tecum Road, and in these city streets. So we're going to go ahead and slow Sky 5 down, and you can see, and I'll tell you, they're just about a block away. So if the suspect were to get out of the vehicle and it became a foot pursuit or the suspect tried to take another car, officers would be right there. As a matter of fact, when we get into these neighborhoods, we're not going to show it to you, but the officers are just about half a block behind. And, of course, you've got that L.A. County Sheriff's Department helicopter that is calling, second-by-second updates on where the suspect is going, what the speeds are, what's going on perhaps inside that vehicle. So they've got a tactical flight officer with binoculars in the left side of the helicopter that's staring down at the suspect and giving very detailed instructions to the officers on the ground. We are hearing chatter that the suspect earlier tossed a bag into the back of a pickup truck in Lakewood, and now there might be speculation from law enforcement that that might have been a weapon. So the original want on this suspect was equipment failure. So they tried to pull the suspect over. The suspect took off out of Upland on the freeway in speeds of excessive 100 miles an hour, driving extremely reckless. And that's when California Highway Patrol made a decision. We've got a helicopter overhead. Let's let them track it, and we will let this guy have a little bit of room. And that strategy paid off as the suspect now continues on Horley Avenue northbound in Downey with that helicopter overhead. Speeds very low right now, so in this residential neighborhood, 30 miles an hour or so. But again, the suspect continues to try and evade authorities. Hold on 1 second. I'll be right back with you. And 5's northbound now. We've got you coming southbound 4. Eleven's got you in sight. I'm going to pedal turn right here. Gotcha. Yeah, I can tell you that sorry about that. I am back. You know, lots of air traffic up here, so occasionally I've got to pause and talk to the other helicopters and airplanes that are flying around. But I can tell you this. Your assessment is absolutely correct. The suspect has dramatically reduced the speeds. We haven't seen the erratic driving that we saw early on in this pursuit. Now surveillance and what they call tracking mode. But again, law enforcement, they don't know what's going on. They don't know if that suspect in the car has been carjacked. They don't know if the passenger is there voluntarily. There's just so many things that are unknown. And of course, they want to protect the other folks that are driving around and the people that are on the ground. But they don't want to endanger anybody by creating what was earlier a very high speed and dangerous pursuit that now law enforcement, they have been, we haven't gotten confirmation, but they believe that it possibly was a weapon that was thrown out of the vehicle into the back of a pickup truck somewhere in Lakewood. So now we are paralleling the 5 freeway. We're making our way northbound, and it looks like we're going to be on Telegraph Road northbound. There you can see that he comes to a little bit of traffic, makes a quick move over to the left, almost as if he was going to drive on the wrong side of the road. There was oncoming traffic, and that is where we stopped. So earlier in the pursuit, this would not have been an obstacle. The suspect was simply driving on the wrong side of the road, blowing through red lights. But now you've got what all of us experience here in Southern California. The suspect stuck in traffic, and there are no officers right behind the suspect. So at this point, it looks like the suspect is getting ready to make a left turn and go back underneath the 5 freeway. I don't believe there is an on-ramp right here to get back on the freeway, but we'll see. And the suspect now continues left turn on Slauson. We are westbound Slauson under the 5 freeway. And again, officers right there about a block away, two blocks away, And as a matter of fact, they've backed off even more than that right now as we take a look. Eye shot out of Sky 5. But again, looks like a suspect's got a brake light out, and that would explain what the equipment malfunction might have been when they tried to pull the suspect over. But at this point, I'm looking out the door of Sky 5. I don't even see, they may have just canceled this pursuit altogether, because we don't see nearly the strength of the law enforcement that we did earlier. So maybe they have called off the pursuit altogether. That would be something that I rarely have seen in my years of covering breaking news, and especially pursuits here in Southern California, where they just simply stop the pursuit. But apparently, again, they went into tracking mode because it was so dangerous. And at this point, they may have all the information they need, and this suspect may just get let go at this point. But we are going to confirm that and get back to you real quick. But now southbound on the 5 freeway from Slauson, and again, nobody behind, I mean, not even a mile behind, and I believe that the helicopter may have been pulled off as well. So a very interesting development here in this, what started as a very high-speed pursuit, and went into tracking mode, and now, again, they may just be letting the suspect go. You know, I would have told you it doesn't make sense, but these days, you know, I've seen it all. These days, I have to disagree. Is this thing over? Got it. Well, again, you know, it's almost haphazard the way that these police cars, I mean, there were a lot of, look at that suspect, even with no officers, I believe, tried to just bang through those cars right there. So even though, you know, the officers are not actively in pursuit, they're not even tracking for the most part, but because they were in that tracking mode, there was a large contingent of black and whites in the area. They seemed to be going back to normal patrol or whatever they were doing before this. And again, it looked like the suspect sort of by accident drove by a couple of black and whites and then tried to jam his way through that intersection. So we are now on Paramount Boulevard southbound, moving back toward Downey. I just asked on the radio, is this thing over? I wanted to know if the suspect or if the PD helicopters, sheriff's helicopters had pulled off. I know that the California Highway Patrol helicopter is in the area, but they're not even over the vehicle at this point. So very unusual circumstances here, as the suspect, not being followed by officers, just tried to get through an intersection, almost because it looked like he accidentally came up on a California Highway Patrol. It looked like an SUV that was going northbound, not related to the pursuit or the surveillance at all. So I'm being told that it's not over. They are still tracking. But again, they have pulled way, way back, and we are going to continue to watch and see, because the suspect was driving so fast. It was so dangerous at first. That's what drove this pursuit to be called off and get into tracking mode. And again, nobody would go after somebody for a broken taillight. So clearly there's going to be something that we don't know about the suspect later on. Again, we don't know the circumstances, but when somebody is driving in that reckless manner, we don't know that, again, speeds in excess of 100 miles an hour, pulling into an alleyway in Lakewood, tossing a bag. Law enforcement seems to believe that it may have been a weapon of some sort. And now, again, on Florence, and as the flow of traffic is moving, the suspect is staying within the law for the most part. We've seen a couple of blown red lights. We've also, just a moment ago, saw the suspect try and wedge his way between two vehicles. So, again, I'd love to be able to pull to a wide shot and show you law enforcement. They're not there. They are, in fact, we don't see any black and whites even within a mile of the car at all. So, again, there's no helicopter overhead, but law enforcement tells me on the radio this is still a surveillance operation. Well, we'll move up so that you can get a better look at that here in Sky. Your wish is our command up here in Sky 5. But, again, very unusual circumstances where really when you look at the makeup of the freeways and the roadways in Southern California, we've pretty much seen it all. And in this case, it's very rare that we see somebody who has posed such a threat to the general public with speeds well in excess of 100 miles an hour, driving on the shoulders, driving very erratically, perhaps even tossing a weapon. And so, again, there's the front windshield look here as we're in the left-hand turn lane of Florence facing westbound. And, of course, we got the sun glaring on the windshield, so it's tough to see inside. But still, we've got law enforcement overhead, but not right overhead, not even within eyeshot of the suspect. And there you can see all the way over to the right side of Florence, and they're stuck in traffic. But look how close he gets to that pickup truck pulling into the gas station there just to get out of traffic. And then cars coming northbound now, and the suspect is now making a right turn going northbound on Garfield, headed back toward the 5 freeway in Bell Gardens here. Now another turn coming up here from the suspect. But, again, no real law enforcement presence at this point. Big U-turn there in the middle of the intersection. But even as recent as just a few moments ago, blowing red lights, still trying to evade we don't know who, because nobody is right there at this point. The police in the area, but not even in the same tracking mode that when we first started this. But again, you have to scratch your head and wonder, why is the suspect driving this way? It's certainly not because of a broken taillight. And five's got y'all. Okay. Copy. Yeah, I just saw like three black and whites continue south. They just took off. Rich, do you need to get closer? Okay. Copy. Really unusual circumstances here. We are now making our way out of, we're in the city of Cudahy, which is just south of downtown LA off the 710 freeway near Florence. But the very unusual suspect started in Upland, California. The original want was reckless driving and an equipment failure. We believe that equipment failure might have been the brake lights on this vehicle. CHP got into pursuit, came out of Upland, and suspect reached speeds in excess of 100 miles an hour on the freeway. That's when they decided that they were going to go into surveillance mode. It made its way down into Lakewood. Suspect perhaps tossed a gun or a weapon of some sort into the back of a pickup truck in Lakewood. Now a left turn right in front of a vehicle into a gas station. But again, there's nobody chasing the suspect right now. The pursuit, for all intents and purposes, is over. And now, suspect's getting out of the vehicle. There is no law enforcement in sight, and they're getting into, or tried to get into, a white pickup truck, tried to switch vehicles. But again, there's no law enforcement there, so there's nobody to stop this thing. And again, you still see very erratic behavior by the suspects that are not even being pursued right now. So ultimately, the officers decided too dangerous for pursuit. We'll go into surveillance mode. The suspect still drove very erratically, and perhaps even a carjacking may be taking place right in front of our eyes here. So we're going to move Sky 5. Hey, 7-5 is going to go below you. We thought perhaps suspects were trying to unload, get into another car, but that is not the case. Suspects still got out, went to a white pickup truck, and then that white pickup truck was locked, got back into this, we believe it's a Honda Accord. Again, there's nobody chasing them right now. All law enforcement have pulled off, and the suspects still are driving in a very erratic way. We don't know the circumstances. They may already know who the suspects are, but at some point, a decision was made. Too dangerous, no more pursuit. Back to you. Probably trying to squeeze through those cars, right? That was a pretty good opportunity for them to move out. Is this still working for you, Rich? Just let me know. Copy. Roger that. Maybe. I mean, they may be running out of gas. They were doing 100 on the freeway earlier. It looked like Kono's truck. Five's got seven. Okay, we got you there, 11. We're going to a little pirouette here. Does it swing through the... Got it. U-turn. That was a... Yeah. It's sort of like a clearing turn. Yeah. That's right. It looks... Yeah, we've seen this before. The suspect got out of the vehicle earlier at a gas station, went behind the gas station, checked to see if a car was open. We've seen lots of commotion coming from the inside of this vehicle, lots of signs. And now, looks like somebody drove up and handed off a package to the driver there. You guys just saw that. So again, no law enforcement here. This pursuit's been over for a little bit, maybe 10 or 15 minutes. They even pulled the air units off. So they must know where or who these people are, and they decided it was just too dangerous to keep going. Earlier we saw the suspect get out of the vehicle, try and get into a pickup truck, and just now suspect got out of this car. You just saw it, tried to get into a car, and somebody ran up with a bag, handed it back in. Earlier today, when this was a pursuit, officers had gone into surveillance mode because it was so dangerous, out of Upland, started with the want of equipment failure, then reckless driving, and again, lots of animation coming from inside this vehicle. We believe it's two male suspects inside. Earlier in Lakewood, it sounded like, from what we heard from law enforcement, they got into an alleyway, tossed a bag that perhaps had a weapon, and then continued on in surveillance mode. And then at some point near the 5 Freeway and Telegraph Road, the suspect just continued on. Law enforcement went away, and they were still driving very erratically. So now that's twice since we've been overhead that we've seen the suspect try and get out into another vehicle. At this point, the continuation of this personal pursuit, I'm calling it, because there is no law enforcement overhead. There is no law enforcement behind, but these guys still trying to get into other cars and continue whatever is going on, and we just don't know what that is right now. So with that, we're going to stay overhead. And we will continue to monitor the situation, but for now, back to you in Hollywood. Good reminder to lock your vehicle. Copy. Still blowing red lights? Yeah, because there was a guy, that silver SUV was trying to make a left turn. Yeah. Copy. Okay. Is there something we can fly to? Oh, yeah. O2. Copy. We are. We're in Southgate on Firestone westbound, just crossed right over the 710 freeway. And again, before we went to break, we saw the suspect get out of the vehicle again and tried to get into what was a locked vehicle. Good reminder to everybody watching that you should keep your car locked when you're not in it. But and then something very unusual, the suspect was approached by somebody else, and somebody threw a bag walked in with a bag. Suspect took that bag and now continues on into this Southgate area. Again, stuck in traffic, nowhere to go, but there's no officers behind. As a reminder for anybody that might just be joining us, it all started in Upland, California with what we believe to be a broken taillight. CHP got in, tried to pull the vehicle over, and that's when the vehicle took off. It became a very high speed and dangerous pursuit on Southland freeways, ending up in Lakewood. That's where the call was made to go into surveillance mode only. But look at that, trying to wedge through cars, front-end damage. I mean, seriously, there's nobody chasing, and he just blows through. Can you imagine how frightening that might be? And now the suspect is out of the vehicle, throwing arms out of the window of this car. So just a really just unusual situation. No pursuit going on at all, but the suspect still crashing into vehicles, stuck in traffic, seems to be agitated. And, again, just a very tough situation right now. Not getting out of the car. We see a lot of this. We see the arms flailing. We see a lot of activity coming. There are two people inside that car, we believe, two males. Earlier at a gas station, they got out, tried to get into another locked vehicle. Didn't happen. And, again, now as we continue westbound, this car just blew through an intersection, hit two other cars. The question mark now, why is law enforcement not here? They must know who these suspects are, and they might be waiting for them wherever their destination might be. But, again, still causing damage here on Southland streets. You just saw it a moment ago, trying to squeeze through a couple of cars here on Firestone. And, again, anytime we've seen the suspect come to a red light, blows right through it. Just a moment ago, we saw pedestrians in an intersection, and the suspect went right through. So certainly law enforcement is probably watching this, and they know that this is going on, but they've made a decision. Here's another red light, suspect blowing right through this red light, right turn, and now going back northbound. So this is going to be Mason and Atlantic here, northbound, the suspect on Atlantic. So now still in Southgate, right on the border here of Southgate, but northbound now. And again, lots of animation coming from inside the car. And again, it started as a reckless driving. That before that was an equipment failure. We believe that to be the taillight out. But still a very dangerous situation with two people that are extremely aggravated, agitated here on Southland freeways and roadways, northbound Atlantic in Cudahy. And again, Sky 5, not the only helicopter overhead right now, but there are several. There were dozens of law enforcement involved. We have not seen them lately. We have not seen them even in the area, even when the suspects stop, get out of the vehicle, check to see if other vehicles are unlocked, and they have not been. But a very unusual turn of events just now when somebody approached the vehicle, handed the bag to the driver. Driver took off and still smashing through intersections and trying to evade. We don't know who, because nobody is chasing these suspects. not a single badge in sight here. We don't see any black and whites. And again, like you said, how terrifying it must be for somebody driving in a minivan and sitting in traffic at a red light, and then all of a sudden this car out of nowhere, these two guys yelling, arms up in the air, and then smashing, ripping the front bumper off of a minivan. Must be terrifying. And again, it continues this trek. I was just talking to Rich Prickett, who's shooting great video for us here in Sky 5 right now. How long can these people go? They've got a full tank of gas out of Upland doing 100 miles an hour. I'd be out of gas by now, but it's going now here as we make our way northbound Wilcox in the city of Cudahy. I just saw law enforcement, but again, it looked like just routine patrol about a block away, not making any move toward this suspect at all. So like you said earlier, just one of the more unusual things that we've seen. Just when we think we've seen it all, something like this comes along, and these guys still driving around and don't know if they're familiar or not. It appeared, like you said, very confident that person walked up, handed the driver a bag, and the drivers kept going. Occasionally, we'll see them stop, get out, check their vehicles to see if they're unlocked. And again, the chase continues, but there's nobody chasing them. 4 or 5's got you. Absolutely. And in fact, even before we got here, we were being told that the suspects had pulled into an alleyway. They tossed a bag that appeared to be maybe a weapon, according to law enforcement. But again, right now, the suspect has turned into off of Florence in the city of Bell now. Again, all these little cities all come together right here, just off the 710 freeway. But this car now pulled into a parking lot. And imagine, you're just... Exactly. And unfortunately, there are people there that have no idea what's going on. So it's a smart and final parking lot right now. There's a gas station, and you can see the suspect kind of cruising into this parking lot right now. Ordinarily, we'd see lots and lots of law enforcement in this situation. But again, we just don't see it right now. I can tell you that they are nearby, but nothing visible to the suspect at this point. But now driving through that parking lot, maybe they didn't see what they needed. And now maybe they were just checking to see if there was a black and white involved. But we've seen the suspects acting very erratically inside that car, now making the right turn out of that parking lot on Florence near Wilcox in the city of Bell. And the suspect now moving into the left-hand turn lane. There are vehicles coming the other way. But just a few moments ago, we saw that when there was the suspect was stopped by traffic, he blazed right through, taking out the front bumper of a minivan and hitting another car. Must have been terrifying for those people that were on the roadway. But look at how animated the driver is right now. We've seen lots of signs, lots of signals coming out of the car. Now a U-turn going back eastbound now on Florence, headed back toward the 710. And again, no law enforcement in sight as the chase continues out of Upland, down to Lakewood, and now here in the city of Bell, headed toward the 710. 11-5's got you. Right door, low. Well, it's because he's back on the freeway. It's probably Bell Gardens, right? Or City of Bell. Well, they're not going to let somebody go into a parking lot and carjack somebody. And 4 or 5 is going to go behind you. I've got you in sight. Thank you. It's ridiculous. What happened? Oh, copy that. Copy. Northbound 710 freeway. Northbound 710 freeway. We just passed Atlantic in the City of Commerce. There is a black and white behind the suspect right now, and we're not sure what department it's from. It's not CHP. It looks like one of the local police departments, perhaps the City of Bell, but or maybe Commerce PD. But earlier we saw the suspect get out of the vehicle, hit a couple of other cars as well. So one of these police agencies made the decision. CHP may have called it off, sheriffs may have called it off, but we are not going to let this happen in our city. And they are now back in pursuit, northbound 710 freeway. Lots of traffic ahead as we approach the 5 freeway. So we'll see what happens. Earlier, the suspect was driving on the right side of the roadway on the shoulder. And that's what we see. You can see we'll try and get in there. And it is Bell Gardens. Bell Gardens PD. In the City of Bell earlier, we saw the suspect drive into a parking lot and perhaps try and take another vehicle. And the vehicles were locked. But that may have been what prompted Bell Gardens PD to get in behind and try and chase the suspect. And if perhaps they get out, take the suspects into custody. We can tell you that there are two people at least inside that car. We've seen them very, very agitated, animated inside the car, throwing their arms around as we continue now northbound on the 710 freeway. Atlantic Bandini is the nearest cross street. And as I said just a moment ago, a lot of traffic here. Driving in the Gore Point, all across lanes there, or looked like they were making a move to get across the roadway. But again, the police department from Bell Gardens, they've just pulled off. So again, a situation where the suspect was in was being pursued once again, and now no pursuit at all. The suspect driving without any police presence behind him northbound on that 710 freeway. Holy moly, look at this, Rich. Look out your door. Caution, wake turbulence coming up. Welcome to LA. I made that right turn. I was like, uh-oh. That is indeed wake turbulence that you just felt. Yeah. Four. Yeah. One, two, three. No, he got off the freeway. So here we find ourselves again southbound on the 710 freeway. Earlier from the Bell Gardens area, Bell Gardens PD went in, got behind the suspect northbound on the 710, and as it was leaving his jurisdiction, the suspect continued on. Bell Gardens PD got off the freeway, and then shortly after that, CHP took over, got in behind the suspect, first one unit, then three, and a helicopter from the LA County Sheriff's Department. They got all the way up to the end of the 710, where it ends up in Alhambra, turned around, got back on the southbound 710 freeway where CHP was still in pursuit. And then just a moment ago, as we crossed the 5 freeway, the suspects continued southbound on the 710 freeway, and the CHP pulled off and out of the pursuit. And now the LA County Sheriff's Department helicopter is backing off as well. So very interesting to watch this as it developed. Started as a pursuit in Upland, California for an equipment failure. That equipment believed to be a broken taillight, two people inside the car. At one point, it was just getting too dangerous, too fast, and the suspect drove down the officers that were in pursuit. They turned their lights and sirens off, and they went into surveillance mode. That seemed to slow the suspect down a little bit. Then it made its way back down into the city of Lakewood, and the Lakewood PD, hold on one second as I'm getting some more information. We're hearing that the Sheriff's Department helicopter now officially has been canceled and is pulling off of this pursuit. So that's over. But we've seen very reckless driving. We've seen traffic collisions. We've seen attempted, the suspects got out of the vehicle, tried to get into cars that were locked. And at one point during this chase, the suspect pulled over a pedestrian. Somebody walked up with a bag and handed the bag to the driver of this car. The driver of the car then took off, drove on, went into a couple of parking lots. We have not seen the driver get out for a while, but again, now there is no chase. Once again, during this, what started as a very high-speed pursuit, no law enforcement whatsoever here, and we continue to make our way southbound on the 710. We have been here before in the cities of Cudahy, Bell Gardens, Commerce, all of those small little cities here just south of downtown Los Angeles along the 710 freeway, and that's where we are right now. As a side note, I'm hearing about a pretty large fire that is burning in Santiago Canyon, which is down toward Orange County and the Riverside County border. So we're too hazy for us to see it, but we are hearing helicopter reports that there is a fire that has just broken out as well. So we are continuing now to watch these suspects as they drive southbound on the 710 freeway back into the city of Commerce. Nobody chasing them at this point. I know. Southbound 710, suspect drove over the gore point, and it looked like for a second there that he was going to be doing a little off-roading, and he is on the curb. So, okay, suspect's out of the vehicle now. Suspect's running now, and it looks like they're running up the the embankment of the 710 freeway. And he does have his bag. Well, and oh, this is dangerous right here. Suspect stopping a big rig here. Truck driver says no way, but suspects in the middle of traffic lanes here. This is a terrible situation for people that are on the roadway right now. Possible carjacking attempt. And now, I believe, this is terrible. No, they're getting into the car. No! Terrible situation here. Suspects stopped on the freeway, and it looks like they have just taken somebody that was just driving around. Oh. Black Nissan Sentra, westbound. Where, what vehicle's in front of it? Okay, right behind the Hummer. Black vehicle behind the black Hummer, or behind the gold Hummer. This is a very dangerous situation. LA County Sheriff's Department just sent a helicopter here to get overhead. We reported what the suspect had done, and the California Highway Patrol had already pulled off the chase, but now the LA County Sheriff's Department that had a helicopter nearby was not working this pursuit or this case. The right behind the Hummer, that's firm. Yeah, two of them in the back seat, it looked like. Yeah, it appeared that it was not force. It appeared that they were asking for a ride, but again, two suspects in the rear seat. They were on Florence, and they tried to get into appeared to be a big rig, and the big rig said no way, kept going, and then they were wandering in traffic. This person drove up. We don't believe that this person is connected at all to these suspects, and they stopped. And is there a black and white right behind him? Yep. Okay, it looks like the LA County Sheriff's Department now sending one of their own vehicles right behind, and two more coming up from the west going eastbound. So it looks like if this was a carjacking, and that's what it appeared to be in our estimation, the LA County Sheriff's Department is on it right now. But again, think about how dangerous this is right now. If the driver of the vehicle, we're going to try and get around, get a shot through that front windshield for you, but a terrible situation here. Ordering the suspects out of the car. One of the suspects, both of them out of the car, now running, and they're running directly toward a couple of sheriff's deputies now. By the LA County Sheriff's Department. It looks like also a local police department as well. We don't know which one it is. Perhaps City of Bell again. But again, a very dangerous situation comes to an end as this car that has been trying to evade officers all afternoon is now over. Yeah, great job getting that stopped. Were we rolling? Oh. Looked like it was 7:10, right? That's where they left the car. That's not the car? That's it. That is the car. Hey, I think they're looking in the wrong car right now. Yeah, it was the off-ramp 710 Florence, and they ran up the embankment. Okay. I'll just stop. I'll park. Also, why are we taking that many hits? Pilot. What mount top? Oh, well, okay. That's my bad. Sorry. It looked like it. Is the other guy in custody? Is he still on the ground? Or okay. Yeah, I think they know. Oh, that guy's being taken into custody, right? Right? It was underneath the overpass? Okay. We haven't seen him unpack anything yet. See you later. What's a 215? Okay. That's what they said earlier. They wanted in a 215.